Tonight, the KCBD investigative team has new details about a case we have followed for more than 3 years.
A Lubbock County District Judge sentenced this man, 45-year-old Billy Jack Limbaugh Jr., to 8 years in prison after he pleaded guilty to domestic assault with a prior conviction. As part of Limbaugh's plea deal, five other charges, including murder, were dismissed.
KCBD News Channel 11's Shaley Sanders has followed this case since Limbaugh's arrest in 2014. She joins us now with the latest. Shaley?
Karen and Abner, in 2014, KCBD ran a number of stories on unsolved murders in and around Lubbock County. One of those cases we focused on was the 2008 murder of Monica Adams. Now, while we were looking into her case, police made an arrest. They charged Limbaugh with Adams' murder and a handful of other violent crimes, including aggravated kidnapping and aggravated sexual assault. Charges now dismissed as part of Limbaugh's plea deal.
Just because somebody gets charged with an offense does not mean they're guilty. And the evidence, particularly in the Monica Adams case, was extremely weak.
Fred Stengel, Billy Jack Limbaugh Jr.'s attorney, says had the state wanted to go to trial on Adams' murder, they would have been ready.
In my opinion, after evaluating the cases, the state had serious issues.
It's something we asked Lubbock County Assistant Criminal District Attorney Sunshine Stanek about.
Over the years, a number of things had happened, events had occurred that directly affected the availability / credibility of some of the victims and witnesses involved in his cases, which led to the plea today.
In January of 2008, police responded to the 2700 block of Northeast Loop 289 for a report of a rape. When police arrived, they reported finding a woman naked with a gash on her head. She told police a man had forced her to perform sexual acts, tied up her hands, beat her with a belt, forced himself on her, smashed a beer bottle over her head, and then threatened her life. The woman escaped and called 911. Investigators collected DNA evidence, but they couldn't find a suspect. 8 months later, in August of 2008, police responded to reports of a body found in a field off of North MLK Boulevard and East Bradley Street. That body was later identified as 29-year-old Monica Adams. She had been missing for about 5 days. Police collected DNA samples from items surrounding Adams' body, but like in the previous case, they were unable to identify a suspect. Almost 6 years later, in May of 2014, police were called to the 4200 block of Idaloo Road in reference to a robbery. A woman told police she had been punched and then tossed out of a man's car. That woman identified Billy Jack Limbaugh Jr. from a photo spread. Law enforcement told us DNA evidence collected during this investigation revealed Limbaugh was the source of the DNA in all three of those cases.
For the people who are watching who are saying, you know, where's the justice for Monica Adams and these other victims, could additional charges come?
Whether or not there's ever additional charges on Billy Limbaugh, I mean, only I can't predict the future. I mean, when a case is resolved, we would have to have new evidence of something or some other crime to pursue an additional case on him.
Sunshine Stanek did want me to make it very clear this plea deal is in no way a reflection of the hard work of law enforcement and wants to thank Monica Adams' family for their patience and their graciousness. Again, Limbaugh was sentenced to 8 years in prison with credit for already having served some time. He has been in jail since his arrest in October of 2014. Karen and Abner.
Thank you.